Greetings, everyone, and welcome. I'm the Chancellor Soul, Mike Boone. You tune in to another edition of Soul Facts, a show highlighting the history and music of legendary artists and preserving their legacies. In this edition features a gentleman who personifies not only class, but sheer essence as a gifted vocalist and storyteller. Soul Facts Spotlight Artist presents Mr. O.C. Smith. Born Tuesday, June 21st, 1932 in Mansfield, Louisiana, O.C. Lee Smith Jr. later moved to Little Rock, Arkansas with his parents when he was just 10 years of age. O.C.'s parents were both teachers. His mother, Ruth, taught music, while his father, O.C. Sr., who also played music, earned his Ph.D. degree, but soon afterwards worked for the government. Smith's parents would soon separate, where O.C. moved to Los Angeles with his mother and would occasionally visit his father in Arkansas each summer. O.C. attended Jefferson High School, where he showed interest in sports, but later learned music under the guidance of his music teacher, Samuel Brown. Smith then attended East Los Angeles Junior College and later trekked down to Louisiana and attended Southern University in Baton Rouge and majored in psychology. O.C. had ambitions in becoming a musician. His early surroundings in music were gospel and blues, but had a passion for jazz and later country. His inspirators in music were Dizzy Gillespie, Charlie Parker, and Nat King Cole in later years. Smith's idol was the one and only Billy Eckstine. In July 1951, O.C. enlisted in the Air Force. During his stay, Smith was a very mischievous individual and often got in trouble with his sergeant. While serving in the Air Police, most of O.C.'s time was spent in special services, entertaining the troops wherever he was stationed, and toured with Horace Heidt. Smith would at times sneak out to sing in local clubs. He spent 15 months in Alaska when he sponsored a talent show. O.C. won first prize. The award was a trip home to New York to see his family and wife Lorraine. And on that trip, his son O.C. III was conceived and born in 1955. That same year, Smith was discharged from the Air Force. He then returned to New York and resumed his singing career by singing in local clubs. His first break came when he got with jazz arranger Cy Oliver and made an appearance on Arthur Godfrey's Talent Scout TV show.
Arthur Godfrey's Talent Scout.
Lipton suits are thrifty, best that you can buy. Always save you lots of M-O-N-E-Y.
His appearance on Arthur Godfrey's show led to a contract with MGM Records. He debuted with his first release entitled You Can't Take My Heart, back with Little Richard's 1955 smash hit Tutti Frutti in 1956.
Wa-ba-ba-loo-mo, ba-ba-bo. Tutti Frutti, all Rudy. Tutti Frutti, all Rudy.
O.C.'s follow-up on the imprint was Lost Horizons and Shangri-La, back with Going, Going, Gone, and Just Kiss Me, back with At Last My Baby's Coming Home, both in 1956. After the stint with MGM, O.C. signed with another New York label, Cadence, in 1957 and issued two singles, If You Don't Love Me, back with Bad Man of Missouri.
Bad Man of Missouri, Bad Man of Missouri.
And Lighthouse, back with Too Many. O.C. lent his magnificent voice on two more New York imprints, including Four on Citation from 1958 to 1959 and Big Top in 1960.
A pretty baby.
Thank you, and now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like you to know.
At this time, Cy Oliver arranged an audition for O.C. with the Count Basie Orchestra after hearing the departure of singer Joe Williams. Smith won the audition and began touring with the Basie Orchestra as a vocalist, for 2.5 years in early 1961.
Do I love you? Oh my, do I, honey? Deed I do.
O.C. enjoyed his tour with Count Basie and thought he was wonderful and gave him free hand vocalizing his style. Smith got the chance to see much of the world, including the U.S. and the West Indies.
That's why I'm always hanging around you.
Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like you to know O.C. Smith.
In an interview with O.C. Smith's son, O.C. III, featured in SoulExpress.com, his son was quoted as saying, "When Dad left Basie, started working, trying to create a career for himself." This was in 1963. He was playing the Concord Room in New York. The marquee had O.C. on it. He wasn't that popular as a solo artist, and they, the people, was mispronouncing his name. They were calling him Ozzy in different names, so he changed the name as initial O.C. for easy identification. He never got it legally changed, though. He just kept it mostly throughout his career. Smith, meanwhile, cut a single for Juggy Murray's New York-based label Broadway entitled "Everybody But Me," back with Mr. Right in 1964.
Everybody, everybody knows, every place she goes, hey, everybody.
One day, O.C. packed up the whole family and put them on a train to Los Angeles, California without him. At first, the family thought it was a vacation. When Smith arrived 3 weeks afterwards in his 1956 Buick convertible from New York with family belongings, it became a permanent stay. While they're in L.A., O.C., along with comedians Red Fox and Slappy White, would drive around looking for gigs. Finally, Smith landed one at Freddie Jett's Pied Piper nightclub. He also toured the military bases in the Far East around 1964 and 1965. In 1966, O.C. Smith's manager Lee Mack got him a contract with Columbia Records and recorded his first single on the label, composed by Kelly Gordon and Dean K. Thompson, entitled "That's Life."
That's life. That's what people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May.
Back with a classic composition by Jimmy Roach, "I'm Your Man."
Now, baby, 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 I am your man. That's life.
"That's Life" was an uncharted release for Smith, but would become legendary for another artist.
You're riding high in April, shot down in May.
While riding his car one day, Frank Sinatra heard the song on the radio and arranged a meeting with O.C. at the Pied Piper Club and asked for Smith's blessing to record the song. O.C. was flattered and said yes. In late 1966, Sinatra's version was released, charting number 4 pop on December 24, 1966, and number 25 R&B on January 7, 1967. Becoming an instant classic in the pop music phenomenon, and was certified a gold record.
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May.
Columbia Records released 2 more uncharted singles on O.C. Smith, "Beyond the Next Hill," back with "On Easy Street."
Look beyond the next hill. Life's on Easy Street. That's where you belong.
And "Double Life," back with "The Season," were issued between 1966 and 1967.
I live a double life of happiness and pain. Such a trouble life where my sunshine turns to rain.
During the summer of 1967, Columbia released O.C.'s debut album entitled The Dynamic O.C. Smith, recorded live. The company gathered over 100 fans, serving food and liquor with musicians consisting of Jack Wilson on piano, Ray Brown on bass, Jimmy Smith on drums, Herb Ellis on guitar, and Larry Bunker on vibes. The LP is considered the first gem among Smith's repertoire of Columbia LP releases. O.C. Smith's fourth classic Columbia release, The Son of Hickory Hollis Tramp, was a song composed by country singer-songwriter Dallas Frazier that told the story of an abandoned mother with 14 children who became a prostitute to make a living. The song was presented to O.C. through songwriter-producer Jerry Fuller through the connection of musician-singer Glenn Campbell, who they both saw country singer Merle Haggard perform it live one night. O.C. recorded The Son of Hickory Hollis Tramp at Fame Studios in Muscle Shoals, Alabama. The song hit number 32 R&B on April 13, 1968, number 40 pop April 20th, and number 2 on the UK charts.
Yes, I'm the son of Hickory Hollis Tramp.
It received radio banishment because of the subject matter dealing with prostitution, and might have prevented the song from obtaining a higher position on both R&B and the pop charts, excluding the UK.
Him and Sally Walker, they up and ran away.
With that being said, it didn't hurt O.C.'s popularity as it accelerated during the activist process.
Promise 14 children, I swear you'll never see.
The Son of Hickory Hollis Tramp was back with The Best Man.
The announcement in the paper said that I'm to be the best man.
It was produced by Jerry Fuller and arranged by the great H.B. Barnum.
That I love you and I'll die when you take his hand.
Another classic Columbia release by O.C. Smith was Mainstream Mission, back with Gas, Food, Lodging.
In the shelter of Main Street Mission.
The song was an uncharted R&B single, but was halted by a deal made by a Chicago promotion man named Jim Green because the song experienced difficulties in sales. However, there was another song that was negotiated as an exchange deal and which halted the continued pressings of Mainstream Mission.
Once I had true love and
this particular Rush song release would make O.C. Smith an international star.
But then for no reason you left and you drove me to Mainstream Mission.
Little Green Apples was composed by singer-songwriter Bobby Russell. As stated by Russell's partner, Buzz Kazan, of the Nashville-based Rising Sun Music publication firm, Little Green Apples was an experiment in composing, anticipating a potential market for true-to-life story songs with more meat in the lyrics. Standard for current hits. Little Green Apples was written for country pop singer Roger Miller to record. Miller's session took place in January 1968 and released from his album, A Tender Look of Love.
God didn't make little green apples and it don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime.
The song hit number 6 on the country western charts and number 39 pop on April 20th, 1968.
Mother Goose is no nursery rhyme.
Singer Patti Page recorded Little Green Apples for her album entitled Gentle on My Mind, where her single was issued from the album in June of 1968.
God didn't make the little green apples, it don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime.
Her version reached number 11 on the Easy Listening charts and stalled at number 96 on the Top 100.
And Mother Goose is no nursery rhyme.
O.C. Smith covered the song for his LP, Hickory Holler Revisited. One morning, a disc jockey in Detroit played Little Green Apples from his album and received a powerful reaction from listeners and a wave of phone call requests of where to purchase the song. The Detroit disc jockey then made a phone call to Steve Popovich, head of promotions for Columbia Records in New York City, to inform him of the reaction to the song from his listeners. It then prompted Popovich to quickly replace Smith's current single, Mainstream Mission, and Rush released his version of Little Green Apples as a single during the late summer of 1968. O.C. Smith's heartfelt, warm masterpiece cover of Little Green Apples is a work of outstanding artistry and brilliantly arranged by H.B. Barnum and produced by Jerry Fuller. And she says hi. Back with Long Black Limousine.
And you're riding in a long black limousine. Oh, God didn't make little green apples. It don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime.
Little Green Apples zoomed to the number 2 position on Billboard Soul Singles chart on October 26, 1968. Number 2 pop also on October 26th, selling over 1 million copies and was certified a gold record. It also won 2 Grammy Awards for Best Country and Western Song and Song of the Year for singer-songwriter Bobby Russell.
Oh, God didn't make little green apples. It don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime. There's no such thing as Dr. Seuss, Disneyland, Mother Goose is no nursery rhyme. Oh, God didn't make little green apples.
O.C. Smith is nominated as New Artist, Contemporary Pop Male Vocalist, but lost both categories to Jose Feliciano. The ceremonies were held at Century Plaza Hotel in Los Angeles, California on Wednesday, March 12, 1969. Columbia Records issued more albums on O.C. Smith, including For Once in My Life, O.C. Smith and Home, both released in 1969, and Help Me Make It Through the Night in 1971.
Where grows the learning tree?
On his O.C. and Home LP, Smith features the title song of the 1969 classic movie, The Learning Tree, and performs the song with warmth and grace. The movie was based on the semi-biographical life of Gordon Parks in Kansas during the 1920s.
That's what a boy should know.
O.C. Smith was asked by film director photographer Gordon Parks to participate in the soundtrack to Shaft's Big Score, a second movie to the now Shaft trilogy. For the soundtrack, Parks requested it singer-songwriter Isaac Hayes to score the music, but Hayes was unavailable, so Gordon wrote the music himself. Smith cut 3 songs for the album, 2 becoming cult classics. First, Blowing Your Mind.
Who splits your heart in a zillion pieces? Baby, you'll blow your mind.
He sure will.
The warm and tender Don't Misunderstand.
Don't misunderstand. We are only strangers on our way to someone else.
And Move On In.
What you gonna do when the buzz come round?
Shaft's Big Score did pretty well in the box office, grossing over $10 million with a budget close to $2 million to produce. The movie was released in early 1972 with lukewarm receptions by the critics, along with a self-titled soundtrack.
When you shove back in the carbine's crack, what you gonna do?
Move it, move on in, move on in,
1968 to 1974, Columbia Records issued more charter hits on O.C. Smith, starting with Isn't It Lonely Together, back with I Ain't the Worrying Kind, charting number 40 R&B on January 18th of 1969.
Isn't it lonely together? Let her go, I ain't the worrying kind.
A remake of the 1968 classic Bobby Goldsboro hit, Honey, I Miss You, back with Keep On Keeping On, number 44 R&B on March 8th, 1969.
Honey, I miss you. Oh, and I'm being good. Keep on keeping on.
Friend, lover, woman, and wife, back with I Taught Her Everything She Knows. Number 25 R&B on June 28th of 1969.
She's a friend, she's a lover, oh, she's a woman, she's a wife. She's the answer to every lonely man dreams of.
O.C.'s second and last R&B top 10 hit, Daddy's Little Man, back with If I Leave You. Number 9 R&B on October 4th, 1969.
I want to take a little walk. Have a little talk with Daddy's little man.
Me and You, back with Can't Take My Eyes Off You. Number 38 R&B on December 27th, 1969.
The flame burns on forever if two lovers play the game, and that's me and you.
The 1964 Four Tops classic hit, Baby I Need Your Lovin', back with San Francisco Is a Lonely Town. Number 30 R&B on September
26, 1970.
A 1970 masterpiece composition by Kris Kristofferson called Help Me Make It Through the Night, back with Diamond in the Rough. Number 38 R&B on December 11, 1971.
All I'm asking is your time. Help me make it through the night.
La La Peace Song, back with When Morning Comes, number 27 R&B in late 1974.
Oh, people, that's my La 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 Peace Song. La 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 La, tell me why can't we get along? That's what happens when morning comes. La-di-da-di-da-di, when morning comes.
La La Peace Song was composed by former Motown singer-songwriter Johnny Bristol and Elizabeth Martin, based on anti-war, racial injustice, and a search for peace. Bristol first produced and released the song on O.C. Smith in 1973, but Columbia Records did nothing to support it, so it would fade to obscurity. In June-July of 1974, singer Al Wilson, fresh from his million-selling 1973 hit Show & Tell, recorded La La Peace Song also. Now, since Columbia Records didn't push O.C.'s version, Wilson, under contract with Rocky Road Records and distribution with the Bell imprint, a spokesman for Bell Records felt that Al Wilson could possibly have a hit with the song. Al Wilson's version of La La Peace Song, back with Keep On Loving You, was issued in September of 1974, with charted number 19 R&B in late 1974. Columbia Records got wind of this and re-released O.C. Smith's 1973 version, where chart competition between the two songs began. Smith's song charted number 27 R&B also on September 1974. But Al Wilson won the competition.
Oh, people, that's my la, 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 la,
Both O.C. Smith and Al Wilson would release self-titled albums entitled La La Peace Song simultaneously, which caused confusion with the consumers. Both O.C. Smith and Al Wilson would lose out shamefully because of terrible promotion by the companies. Both versions by O.C. Smith and Al Wilson will always remain classics and remembered as one of the most celebrated heartfelt tunes ever put on wax.
It's not safe to fly. You might get hijacked to an unknown land.
In 1974, O.C. Smith's career and personal life slowly began leading down toward the bottom of a slope. His association with songwriter-producer Jerry Fuller had terminated. Smith also no longer had full support from Columbia Records, as they were under investigation for payola, where O.C.'s manager was sent to prison within the shuffle. Smith's reputation was falsely under slander, claiming that he had gambling debts, even rumored to have owed the mafia from the investigators because of Smith's uncooperative ways of providing information for them. After the calamity was finally resolved, Columbia wanted to resign O.C., but after long contemplation from Smith, and then suddenly changed his mind and signed him with the company, Columbia had the final say and refused to re-sign him. Their association was sadly also terminated.
But I won't let it get me down. This whole world keeps spinning around.
O.C. III, Smith's son, said that, "My father never wanted to be controlled. He was always the kind of person that would stand up for himself. He always had to have the last word. All he wanted to do was create music." After he left Columbia Records, O.C. divorced his wife and left home. Smith had trouble finding work in the industry, so he went underground. However, O.C. managed to find work at a small club in L.A. called the Memory Lane. Afterwards, he began studying The Science of Mind by Dr. Frank Rochihu. In 1976, O.C. session tour drummer John Guerin was a member of the L.A. Express Band, brought Smith a mid-tempo beautiful tune called Together. Back with I Just Couldn't Help Myself.
Most of the time, a chance to grow. Just couldn't help myself.
Together we take it on. Together we make it go.
Together charted number 62 R&B on the Caribou label in New York.
Together we build a bond.
A self-titled album, Together, was issued in 1976.
And we know, together we know.
From 1978 to 1987, O.C. Smith recorded more charter hits on various labels, such as Love to Burn, number 34 R&B on Shady Brook in 1978.
I got love, take as much as you need, 'cause I got love to burn.
Dreams Come True, number 92 R&B, 1980.
Dreams come true. But you know that means bad ones too.
Love Changes, number 68 R&B on Motown, originally released on South Bay in 1982.
We're going through love changes. They blowing my mind. Don't need no more love changes.
And Three or Rendezvous, What You Gonna Do, number 53 R&B.
What you gonna do when the sun don't shine?
A remake of Barry White's 1974 classic million seller, You're the First, My Last, My Everything, number 52 R&B.
You're the first, you're my last, my everything.
Both songs issued in 1986, and Brenda, number 58 R&B in 1987.
Oh, Brenda,
OC's albums from 1979 to 1982 includes Love Is Forever and Love Changes. Throughout the years, O.C. Smith made great television appearances, including American Bandstand, the Johnny Cash special with his son O.C. III, duetting for Once in My Life, Playboy After Dark, Sammy and Company, Sammy Davis Jr.'s weekly variety series, Soul Train, the John Davison Show, and among others.
I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'll be strong.
O.C. Smith's popularity grew among the Carolina Beach music fans and became a principal performer. Smith was nominated 6 times at various Beach Music Awards ceremonies and won 5. Years later, O.C. Smith became a pastor and founder of the City of Los Angeles Church in Los Angeles in 1996, where he ministered for 16 years. Smith gave up unhealthy habits like smoking, drinking, sweets, red meat, and constantly exercise to keep in shape. The ministry changed his whole perspective of life.
After all,
in 1993, O.C. released After All Is Said and Done on Triune, and in 2002, a CD entitled I Give My Heart to You.
I give my heart to you, unconditional and true. I give my heart.
O.C. III said in SoulExpress.com, I Give My Heart to You was released posthumously. He was overworked. He did a service that day in church and went home. When I finally made Thanksgiving dinner at his house, it was about 6 o'clock in the evening. Soon after dinner, he fell asleep. At 7 o'clock in the morning, I get the call. He had gone to bed, started complaining about gas pains. Got up and went to the bedroom. He walked to the den and he was found lying on the floor, where he died at some point.
I couldn't believe my eyes. Heaven sent you to me, girl, an angel in disguise.
O.C. Smith sadly passed away on Friday, November 23rd, 2001, at the age of 69. 4,000 people would attend his funeral. Governor Jim Hodge proclaimed June 21st, 2002, O.C.'s birthday, as O.C. Smith Day in South Carolina. He was survived by his wife, Robbie, his 4 children, and 10 grandchildren. O.C. was posthumously elected to the Carolina Beach Music Hall of Fame in November 2002. The vocals of O.C. Smith would continue to echo softly through the hallways of millions of listeners' minds. His gifted abilities as a performer and a storyteller combined will always be revered and cherished in our hearts for many years to come. Let's just be thankful that the music outlives the man. Until we meet again musically, I am the Chancellor of Soul.
Oh, God didn't make little green apples. It don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime.
Soul Facts, a show written, created, produced, and copywritten by the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone, and is a nonprofit music presentation.